end game program and be done with them.
Endgame it shall be.
Hi, and welcome back to Fuller's Figures. Today, I'm going to take a look at the new G.I. Joe classified series, Cobra, Scrap Iron, and Anti-Armor Drone. I've been so excited to get this one here. I pre-ordered it from Big Bang Comics here in Dublin. I got the email notification there during the week that it had come into stock, so I popped over after work to pick it up. And I'm so happy that I did pre-order because this thing is awesome. I just can't wait to get this out and take a look at it. So of course, a big thanks to Big Bang Comics, who continue to look after collectors and continue to get this line in, which, you know, I know myself and many others really do appreciate that. Looking at the box art then, of course, it's plastic free packaging. It's in this kind of updated style that they've been doing with the last few figures, which is a lot cleaner and a lot nicer than other offerings we have had in the line. So we get this picture here of the figure in action with the drone. The background, we've a couple of Sky Strikers flying off. We get a digital image here of the character, which is pretty gnarly, great artwork. Some of the accessories there on the side that come with the pack. And yeah, I do like, you know, for plastic free packaging where you don't get to see what's inside, I do like the style that they've gone with. We got a Cobra logo down here, a couple of warning with choking hazards, plastic free packaging propaganda, and the Hasbro logo. Side of the box then, if I can fit it, we get a kind of a bigger image of the character that we got in the front of the box. I love this artwork. It's absolutely fantastic. He's number 74 in the line. This side here, we get a QR code, which I think brings you to Hasbro website, and we get his file card down here, which you have to go onto the app to interpret, which I've never done. Another image of the character and his number there. Back of the box then, and we get this look at the figure. So he stands 6.2 inches tall. We get a look at some of the accessories that come with him, along with the missiles and the blast effects. And then this side here, we get a close-up of the face, which of course they've gone with an amazing sculpt on this guy. I really can't wait to see it in person. We get a look at the rockets taking off from the drone with the blast effects, and then just a close-up of some of the stuff molded onto the figure. Usual legal jargon on the bottom here, as well as the bottom of the box, and that's it. So let's get Scrap Iron out, take a good look at it, go through what he comes with, and I'll tell you what I think is this figure's playability factor. So I've unpackaged Scrap Iron and the drone, I've put them together, and I have them up on my spinning wheel here for you to see. My first impressions are really good. I'm so impressed. They've done a cracking job on this. Not only did they capture the vintage look of Scrap Iron reimagined in 6-inch modern form, but they've done a fantastic job reimagining the drone as well. And they give us these extra world building pieces that we really want from a toy line. This is G.I. Joe done right. I took my time when I unpacked the figure and I went through all the joints individually, and I have to say I'm happy with the quality of the figure. There's no issues there whatsoever. He's doesn't have any sort of paint blemishes yet that I can see, and all the joints are moving freely. The drone as well, it's sort of beautiful in its simplicity, so there's a little bit of articulation in it, but there's not enough there that can sort of get broken or go wrong. I've used the inlay card as well from the packaging behind the little scene here with the drone and Scrap Iron, because I think they've done a great job in the packaging. Looking now more closely at the figure, and I suppose the face is where we can really see this figure being a standout job by the Joe team, because the vintage one came with a molded helmet and they wanted to make this one removable, so they had to go and give this guy a bit of character, and they've done a really good job on that. Starting off at the top here, you can see he's got this mohawk with this great sort of sculpt on the hair on top. It really does stand out. It's beautiful, and that of course comes down here onto this gnarly looking face, and they've done such a cool job looking capturing that snarl he has. Looking to the side here, you can see he's got some battle scars running down from the forehead all the way down to the front of the face here, along with some on the side. Moving over to the other side then, you can see his eye is damaged obviously from some blast, and that's carried over onto this amazing sort of burn scar he has on the side of his face, and just excellent sculpting on that. It really just molded beautifully, just looks so sinister. The only thing is, I suppose, a splotch or two of a bit of a darker paint or red paint might have just sort of brought it out a bit more, but look, that's only a small criticism. It really looks good. They've done a fantastic job capturing, like I said, building a character behind or underneath the helmet. Moving down then, the rest of the body of the figure, we can see he's got this sort of body plate here over him, which is very close to the vintage one. It's got a pocket molded on here along with a couple of grenades on this side. We've got buckles here with a beautiful sort of silver paint up on that comes through and really looks bright. I love it. Moving along the back then, and you can see the different tones, and they've used a brighter red in the back of that, but it has that pattern molded into it as well. They've done a really good job on that. Colour scheme then, again, sticking closely to the vintage one, he's got this navy suit underneath, so he's got this Cobra logo here on the top of this arm, along with these sort of elbow pads, and just black gloves then. Moving down to the legs, they're pretty simple. He's got this sort of textured bodysuit carried on down, but he does have these knee pads, and down to these sort of boots that have a touch of red on each side of them, which just gives a bit of uniformity to the look of the aesthetics of the figure. On the belt then, you can see here, again, the couple of paint apps. You've got some black here along with the same sort of colouring used on the buckles above, on the belt buckle. That's carried down these straps, and he's got his holster on the right leg there. And there's just another strap here on the other side. Again, just adding to the aesthetics of the character. Looking then at the accessories, he comes, of course, with his helmet, which has this sort of visor going across it here with a little Cobra logo up on top. Again, a nice clean sculpt job. We've got a paint up here on these earpieces on either side of it, like kind of a light grey, and really stands out well. And that slots onto the character really easily. And if I just get it to sit straight on the nose there, you can see then he's much more closer to the vintage look scrap iron. But so cool that we get that removable helmet. He comes with this sidearm. Now, this is just molded in plain black. It is a nice mold, and it is a new sculpt for the sidearm. So, pretty nice. Of course, he probably doesn't need this too much. He's got that big drone with his missiles. That slots straight into the holster down into the side of the leg and fits neatly onto the figure. The last sort of scrap iron accessory then is his little control pad for controlling the drone. So we can see there it's got a nice sort of sticker over the top that has this display screen with sort of some imagery on top, a couple of sort of joypad buttons here along with some more buttons down here, and two antennae. So again, another nice piece, and that slots nicely into his hand, and you can have him holding it like that for your photographs. So again, a nice accessory, and the colour scheme really fits in with the rest of the figure. I'm really impressed with that. Looking more closely at the drone itself, and again, another stunning job, another stunning sculpt. This comes in two parts, so the top piece here and the legs, and they just slot on together on a simple ball joint, which was easy to do. And because it's on that ball joint, it gives you a bit of articulation when moving it around. So of course you get your 360, and it gets some up and down movement on that as well. The front here, we get our two slots for our rockets, of course, along with these camera lenses on the front here, probably for his infrared or his guidance of his missiles. And they come in three different paint apps. So we get the dark black one here. We have a green sort of light and a yellow light up on top. Really nice touch. I do like that. We have sort of an antenna or an aerial on this side, and then some other sort of camera or light on the other side there. On the side then, we get this anti-tank 002. With this M logo, and on the other side then we get this bit of writing here, piezoelectric SN with some serial number that has Cobra at the end. So that's a really nice touch. So you can see this kind of slots here on the side, obviously vents for when the missiles are taken off. And then moving on to the back then, we get this beautiful grill with a Cobra logo molded in with nice silver paint up, and then a couple of red lights at the back, because it's really important to know when your drone is breaking while in the battlefield. Moving down to the legs then, and it's just sort of molded together, so there's no movement on the tracks, which I don't mind whatsoever, but they do have a kind of a softer rubber mold plastic over them, which is nice. It's a nice feel, and they do look the business. Coming to the side then, we just get a couple of paint apps for different sort of parts of the hydraulics on the system here. And the front then, we get the again more vents that are painted in red paint there. So kind of simple, but does exactly what it needs to do. Really impressed with this. And again, it's just such a cool addition to your G.I. Joe display. This is going to look awesome on a shelf, or if you're taking any photographs with it, it gives you loads of options. Now, the rockets themselves. So, we get two rockets, and they come, of course, with laser-guided writing on them, as well as these numbers, Hero 4. So, I'm not sure what that is, whether that's a callback to the vintage one or not. One of my rockets is kind of a bit bent, but I've been working on it because it's a soft enough plastic, and I'm sure I'll straighten it out in time. So, to get these into the drone, they just slot in like that. I'll do the other one here, and that's a simple fit there. And you can see how awesome they look, sticking out of the front there, just waiting to be fired. And I suppose the last thing to look at then is the blast effects that come with scrap iron, and they are pretty awesome as well. So, you know, we get these pieces here which look like sort of ground explosions, which has a twirly effect. This has a bit of smoke molded on the bottom that's painted in white. It's a soft rubber, so you can see my flame effect is veering off to the side here, just like the rocket. It's a soft plastic, so I'm just trying to work it back. But again, really nice. So if you're trying to do up a sort of a diorama with your Joes that, you know, they're an impact site, these can just sort of fit around them like such. They're really cool. We get this one here, which again is another sort of puff of smoke effect with some blasts coming off, which are sort of a different color, the orange color. A simple paint job, and again, just does the spot. And then the last one, we have this sort of fruit effect, like, you know, this is the blast at the back of the rockets, so an explosion with sort of smoke being pushed out from the impact as well. So again, beautiful little additions to get with any sort of action figure or set like this. This is what we want. Now, the last effect that I want to show you is the one for the rockets, and this is cool. So we get these two pieces here, which of course has this the flame effect, but then back into smoke, so it looks like the trail of the rockets. And if we want to use those, we can just remove the rockets from our drone, and you can see there, there's just a hole that this pegs into, not a simple fit like that. And that pops in and just sticks at the back. And you get two sizes. You get a longer one and a shorter one. And put in like that. So that really just gives the effect of, you know, the rockets taking off out of the drone. And that's just going to add to any sort of shelf display or diorama that you want to set up with scrap iron. And, you know, like I said, there's loads of photograph opportunities with this guy. Just have to straighten my rocket out first. And that's been my look at Scrap Iron and the Anti-Armor Drone from G.I. Joe Classified Series. I've Scrap Iron posed here with a couple of Vipers just to show off how that colour scheme really fits in with the rest of your bad guys on your Cobra shelf. And I think that's where this has really hit all the right buttons for me. Not only is the aesthetics of this figure brilliant, they stay true to the original version of the figure, but they also, you know, brought it into a modern look in 6-inch form, but the colour scheme just slots right in alongside your other Cobras on your display shelf, which is pretty cool. The accessories are all great. I have no complaints about this whatsoever. I'm going to give this a solid 10 out of 10. For me, this is value for money. I know I'm going to get a lot of enjoyment out of setting up different photographs with this, and for me, that's a big part of how I like to collect my toys and use them. So the playability factor for me is a solid 10 out of 10. Now, if you want to see more videos on Scrap Iron and the Anti-Armor Drone, I can highly recommend James over Ratface44 Reviews. He's just done an excellent review of his one, along with Chris over at Mod Extra Games and Collectibles. He done a video there a couple of weeks ago. He got way ahead of me and has a fantastic video out. I'm going to leave both their links down in the description below. If you like, you can follow me over on Instagram at Fuller's Figures, where I like to post stuff fairly regularly. But if nothing else, I really hope I see you here in the next one.